Assalamu alaikum. The topic that we are going to discuss today is anger management in marriages. Anger is a very negative emotion and it could cause a lot of hurt and pain. This anger could vary in intensity from irritation, annoyance, fury or rage. I have seen so many marriages break due to two reasons. One is anger and the other is ego. Both of these go hand in hand. Now we need to understand what are the causes of anger. Anger could be caused due to hurt, frustration, harassment, injustice, unfair criticism, and of course threats. In a marriage and in a marital relationship, the couple can be very strongly bonded, but their relationship could be very delicate at the same time. Anger is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a test for the couple's level of tolerance, level of compromise, and their patience. So now we need to understand what is the danger of anger in a marriage. In most cases, anger leads to divorce. And our Prophet once said, of all the lawful things, divorce is the most disliked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why we need to learn how to manage our anger. Therefore, you have to make sure you do not say anything that you would regret later. And this Allah has made it very easy for us. Just follow the example of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he is the biggest example for us to follow. And believe me, my dear brothers and sisters, shaitan uses anger as a tool. So we have to find ways of how the shaitan should not use this tool to separate the spouses. So let me move on to the next point. So we have two solutions. One is control your feelings. When you get into an argument, just think. Think that it is a bump in your life and find a way how you can get over it. The second, think that it's only a difference of opinion. And when it's a difference of opinion, alhamdulillah, it could be regarding finance and it could be regarding raising your children. So, keeping these two things in mind, let us say we do not get into arguments with each other, because arguments will only lead to frustration and it will aggravate the situation. There is no solution in an argument. I would recommend to you is stop and think. Keep a calm head and stop talking. We must follow the example of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So whenever he was angry with any of his wives, he would just stay quiet and calm. This would help him resolve the situation and the situation would be forgotten. Tradition has it, the best way to control your anger is do ablution, that is wudu. Drink a glass of water. And if you're standing or sitting, just lie down. This is exactly what our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. And that is exactly what we need to do. My advice as a layman or a common human being is do not argue because it aggravates the situation. Do not say something you would regret later. Never be angry with your spouse and go to sleep. Now let us come down with key solutions for this problem. The first thing is think of it as a challenge to your beliefs. Sometimes we all are brought up with different ways of life. This you need to question, what did I do that led to this situation? Second, as I've already told to you, wait it out. Just stop, be calm. Third, step outside your comfort zone or think as a third person. I would like to give you an advice is when your friend comes and gives and shares with you something and he says that he had an argument with his wife, you would give him a piece of advice. Now put yourself in those shoes and think what you need to do as a third person. And alhamdulillah, this would really help you. The most important point to remember is communication, communication, communication. Keep your passage or your airway clean. by doing communication with each other and nip the problem at the bud so it does not grow into a bigger problem. So to keep this key solutions in mind, I would give you one last tip, and that is, remember the best thing about your spouse. Remember the good things that you love about your spouse, and inshallah, this would help you fall in love again. I hope you have benefited from my video. Please do not forget to press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel. Assalamu alaikum and have a blessed day.